is love. Mm-hmm. So this is love. So this is what makes life divine. I'm all aglow. Hello, how was your week? Have you had a stressful week? This video is going to be very relaxing, so perhaps you could grab a glass of wine or coffee or a cup of tea, and hopefully this will just let you release any tension or worries, and you can just come into the kitchen with me. I'm preparing for an aperitivo. I'm sure you've heard of aperitivo before if you've been to Italy. It's very, very popular among Italians. It's that time for drinks and snacks just before dinner, around sunset maybe. But we're in Italy, so we're not talking about salted nuts and corn chips. No, we're talking about really delicious antipasti or snacks that can keep you going, because aperitivo can sometimes go on until, you know, 9 or 9:30, and then people go to dinner at 10, or at least my friends in Rome and in Florence. And for this aperitivo, I want to do options that are vegetarian and one of them vegan. So I'm doing this absolutely delicious recipe for hummus, crema di ceci. Chickpeas are used so often in Italy, but my recipe I like to do with roasted garlic, lemons, tahini, olive oil, and it's so good. It's so good that I'm gonna serve it with like a crudité. Crudité is a French word, but comes you can link it with the word crudo, which means raw in Italy, in Italian, scusa. And so that's it means crudité means like a raw vegetable served with a dip. And so I'm serving chopped raw vegetables with my hummus. Admittedly, it is easier in Italy because the vegetables are so good in their natural state. Like, you get the fennel, for example, and I find when I'm just unpacking the groceries, I come nibbling on it like I would, I don't know, a freshly baked baguette or something. Something really irresistible that you just think, oh my gosh, I have to taste it now. So yes, raw vegetables are very good in Italy, but this hummus is so creamy and packed with flavor that I find generally even people who hate vegetables end up devouring the whole plate because it's so good. I will put the recipe on my website, carlyflavelle.com, but I'm going to be making quite a large portion because you'll see I made an initial quantity and then I thought, no, that's not enough. It's just, it's the type of, what was it with, I can't remember which recipe it was, maybe the lemon ricotta cake or my cookies or something. And you all said to me, yes, it's not, they just disappear in a second. And this is one of those recipes. So you want to make a good big quantity. Also because I find it's great for lunch the next day. Like, I just use it as a nice healthy lunch, and it's easy. I have the hummus in the fridge and the vegetables already chopped. Then I'm going to do some stuzzichini. Stuzzichini are like little nibbles or canapes, and it comes from the verb stuzzicare. Stuzzicare means to tease, so you're just like teasing the appetite. And my stuzzichini are going to have puff pastry, and then have roasted red onion and zucchini and capsicum or peppers if you're North American, and dried porcini mushrooms and ricotta. And again, that's vegetarian, not vegan because of the pastry, but you could put pancetta on top if you wanted. And they're super easy to make, both of them, and very, very delicious. They're real crowd pleasers. So yeah, even if you're not socializing because you're in lockdown, you'll note at the end of the video, usually I serve my hummus in one big pot, but for this, I do separate plates. I did like a separate plate of vegetables and hummus for each couple, so that then no one's dipping from the same pot with anyone that they don't live with. So yeah, I hope you enjoy it, and let's begin. Thank you.
This is love. So this is love. So this is what makes life divine. I'm all aglow. And now I know.
And now I know.
The key. Has wings and I can fly. I'll talk.